I was assaulted October 1st, 2012. I have to go to the eye doctor tomorrow. I'm continuing to have problems seeing out of my eye. She made a hole in my retina. But think about it. It happened in a Soho office, Dr. Andrew Finkelman, 155 Spring Street. Why would the NYPD protect that medical office? All right, first of all, we've had a huge scandal after September 11th. All these years later, there's NYPD that were supposed heroes, downtown 9/11, that put in fake disability. Then you have the Adrian Schoolcraft case where Chief Marino, he was busted with, I think, about 20 other NYPD officers illegally. He claims not, by the way, but they were using human growth hormone, a kind of steroid. You're not supposed to use it. So for me, just in general, I'm really suspicious of medical doctors and the NYPD. That's just me. I'm trying to figure out why the receptionist office manager, she sits at the very front desk. In my opinion, she violated my patient rights in many ways. And my personal business, they all seem to know my name. To this day, I don't know their name. Don't know their names. Believe me, I want to take legal action and learn everybody's names, including in the police department that's involved, and why there's no arrests. Currently, Commissioner Bratton's NYPD say, we can't do anything because you're suing. Lawyers say that simply isn't true. It's yet another excuse. If my last name was Bloom de Blasio, it would be very different. You know, I'm making a pun on Bloomberg de Blasio. It's the tale of two cities. If you're wealthy and connected, you get justice. If you're not, probably you're not going to get justice. But this story's, something's very wrong here. And the police know. I've handed out thousands of justice cards. I'm calling for a new commission into NYPD corruption. Now my cards ask to contact Eric Holder. Eric Holder says contact the FBI, which I've done. I mean, something's very, very wrong here. Why would the police go to this level to protect a doctor's office in Soho from assault? And they will not let me upgrade to second degree assault. A charges against my attacker, Delita Hooks. They haven't arrested her for a false cross complaint. Internal Affairs knows that the detectives involved sealed her false cross complaint in under a year with their crime of coercion. And what did Internal Affairs do? They let Detective John Fergona retire, and they let his supervisor, Lieutenant Angelo Burgos, retire. I have information that was part of the city's motion to dismiss my case that further incriminates them. It tells you also that I feared for my safety. They tell you that they perceived Delita Hooks, the office manager for Dr. Andrew Finkelman, to be illiterate. That's not the right word they use. They use the word that she doesn't speak English very well. She's 135 pounds. That's great to know when she's grabbing my hair and pulling me. She's trying to pull me down the hall. And I used her momentum, got her down to the ground after she struck my body three times. She would not let go. She's at least 135 pounds pulling on my head, my arthritic neck. She caused floaters in my eyes. She damaged my cervical spine. No rest. Stay tuned. We're waiting for the federal judge to rule. And if need be, I will do a second lawsuit against the city of New York and the police department and internal affairs again. I do believe there'll be news. I know there has to be because a judge has to rule one way or another, but stay tuned.